injuries we have. I'll have you for this one of those dice.
Being soaps, isn't it?
Yeah, just because we couldn't pay.
Hey, slot. How much you got?
Nothing, Dad.
You wouldn't be lying to me now, would you?
Oh, Dad. Would I lie to you? I would. Would I?
Just you try it, that's all. Hey, Polly. What you got?
The pox. Want it?
Oh, talk about money, aren't I? I'm thoracic.
I haven't got any money, have I? I wouldn't be standing out here if I did, would I?
Right, home coach. Lend us a few bob, mate.
Oh, I want to be fair to you, damn boy, but most of all, I want to be fair to me. If I lend you a few bob, where's me profits, eh?
Abandon hope, all ye heathens, prepare to be consumed by the fires of thine own destruction, for the day of retribution is at hand.
Oh, come on, mate, you want to have a good time, don't you? It's bank holiday, isn't it? It's Saturday, isn't it? Oh, delight, Saturday night, oh, bleeding week you've been hiding. Now you're here, clouds disappear, go down the sun is shining.
Go down the sun is shining.
Get him a special gift. He has suffered with you all. He used to be a man of proof. ground. That's the sort of bloke you use.
Gonna do with you. She done me a favour. I'll do her a favour someday.
The only favour you could do us, Mate Dozer, is to take a running jump off Summer Bridge.
What you laughing at?
All right, Myra. Bloody well, thing. You're a lady, don't you? Well, I'll bet you ain't even got any drawers on.
Oh, you're taking your hands off me, you dirty what? Loud, filthy, stinking son of a dog, Ollie!
I'm the girl you all know, who's generally nice, though generally wouldn't look at twice. I'm simple, shy, secure, very quiet, rather pure. And though I might seem generally tough, I'm quite just an ordinary lady, with ordinary ways, with a clean, a very ordinary mind. I'm shy and complicated, or less previously stated, unaffected by the ravages of time.
Is fine. biscuit from the lower jaw, souvenir of a barroom brawl. She left Ireland's green lands for London, for the call of the bright city lights. And now she's lying alone on a cold mortuary stone, not one of the prettiest sights. She was born in the county of Devon, in a home full of trouble and strife. And Polly Ann ran away in the hope that one day she might get some more out of life. There follows a trail of disaster that's enough to make each of us shriek. Of a baby still born, of a body well worn with disease of which none of us speak. She was shameful and lustful and wicked. And she went with strange men every night. She was evil and shameful and filthy. So let us all say,
serve you right!
She made her own bed, let her lie on it. And why should we hang our heads down in shame? Well, but your circumstance never gave her a chance, so why should we share any blame? No, let us not linger upon it. Let us all fill our glasses and sing. Let us all warm ourselves by the fire. Let us all close our ears to such things. And there ends the story of Polly. But there's just one last thing I must say. That this toothless old hag, lying dead on a slab, was just 15 years old today.
Alleyways and don't go near the river. you on a time, if I like.
Righto. What do you want?
I'm looking for a girl who used to live in the Westminster area, but then she left. I believe she's living somewhere around here.
Nah, I've never seen our lady live down here.
Well, she wasn't exactly a lady.
You should know, Laurie. You used to live up the West End, didn't you?
Shut your mouth, please.
Oh, couldn't tell a lie, could I, dear?
Nah, I've never seen anybody like that. What was her name?
Her name was Jeanette. Could be anything now, of course. Could even be Marie. Well, nothing to say.
Yes, you've had your time's worth.
You don't think I'm going to let you go now that I've found you?
A trap! A trap!
A trap indeed! My search is at last over.
Please let me go. Have mercy.
Mercy? Who are you to ask for mercy? You who have ruined everything you have ever touched.
Oh, but I'm innocent. I swear I am. I swear by all that is holy. You have the wrong girl.
Ah, you said it.
Shut your bleeding mouth, Miss Doctor. Please let me go. I'll do anything.
Anything?
Anything.
Or it's your birthday. No. My mind is made up. For years I have been searching for you. Now that I have found you, the final curtain can fall and the play can end.
And about bloody time, too.
You shut your mouth then, doctor.
Shut yours, Liz,
or you'll swallow the place.
Too lost to come in here. I apologise for my friend's behaviour. Pray continue.
You are in my power and there you will stay. Your cries are in vain. Your pleas are in vain. Your protestations are in vain.
Yeah, social bloody acting.
I remonstrate with you. But, no, we are blessed tonight with a sensitive, artistic, and need I say articulate audience, but please sit back and enjoy the scintillating performances of Whitechapel, nay, London, nay, England, most celebrated thespian who has graced us with his company tonight. I beg your pardon, madam. Does your husband know you're here?
If you don't keep quiet, sir, I shall leave. I'm trying to play a dramatic scene with this lady.
Lady? Burke. Don't you know what the lady's really doing for a living? Is she selling something tasty on a corner of the street? We can give you a little clue by saying she's expensive. And her times are divided between off and off her feet. Now the trade is quite secret, so don't breathe a word to mother. It's the oldest profession, and we don't mean making sweets. Here's another one who's acting. You can see the way she's walking. When she stops and gazes upward, she's not looking at the night. She's waiting for the bloke behind to get a little nearer. When he does, she'll drop her handkerchief and not away inside. The train is quite secret, so don't breathe a word to mother. It's the oldest profession, and we don't mean making jam. What a lie, so don't leave, what a lie, to spend the old age jolly, what a lie. But on the other hand, it's true, opportunities are few, and it can't be worse than starving, what a lie. Satisfy you, darling.
You keep your filthy remarks to yourself, I'll get my brothers to come and do you in.
Brothers? Oh, come on, you don't even know your real mother was. Come along, chaps, I'll show you where we can find some real ladies.
Ladies?
You think you're oh so clever with your fancy dancing way? Well, no.
as shock, he hasn't seen a rock clock. She must be 46. If she's a day, now I'm not at all religious in the true sense of the word. And I've done some naughty things myself, that's true.
That's true.
But here I draw the line, you wouldn't catch me selling mine. But you're welcome to my sister, if you got a bob or two.
What you have had it, your boy, it's one more. You want to
been down there. Come on. Can't sleep there. You all right?
It was only a violet look from Mother's grave. And I say that I'll be going over it.
No, no, don't be saucy. You'll be getting along home.
Oh, there, Ducky. This is it. Ain't it lovely? Needs a bit tidied up, of course. Drop in any time.
Look, you can't sleep on the streets. It's against the law.
What law? You can't turn a girl out of her home? That is against the law. I'll call a copper.
Look, you've had enough of it for one night.
I ain't got nowhere to go. Can I come back with you?
I don't think the missus would understand somehow. You be a good girl and nibble on to Mitre Square. If you get done round there, I ain't got a right out of me port.
You couldn't spare me tuppence, could you?
Now where do you think I'm going to get tuppence from?
If I did something wrong, would I get put in prison for the night?
Done something wrong, have you?
Yeah, I pinched the sack.
Well, you needed it, didn't you?
Well, what about if I broke my
sack? Now, just you behave yourself. We got no room for the likes of you. Just you be gone when I be coming round this way again, or there'll be trouble.
Just like a violet. Is that? Is that? Is that?
Then you are a mind in your own piece. When out of the shadows comes a big black cat. Grips up, eyes shut, your bleeding throat scum. Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out. Late one night, you're walking down an alley. Suddenly a shriek will make your blood run cold. Grips up, eyes shut, your bleeding throat scum. Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out. She's a leap upon the floor. Look around. Right now, she was a fair old looking tart.
once again ask you to be upstanding for the loyal toast to our much beloved and kind-hearted Queen Victoria. God bless her.
I really don't see why they should have all the fun. know where I might find Murray Kelly?
No. But if I see her, who shall I say was asking for her?
Doesn't matter.
Nice name. Jewish.
excuse me, where does Murray Kelly live?
Over there, mate.
Murray? Murray, I want to speak to you.
Oh, go away.
I was wondering if you had any of Annie Chapman's things left.
Oh, how should I know?
Well, you seem to end up with the belongings of the dead.
Look, if there was anything left, there ain't now. Unless this old bat's any good to you.
I want to talk to you.
I don't feel like talking.
It's drunk, aren't you?
What if I am? Want to make something of it?
Not particularly.
Oh, not particularly. Go on, get out of it. You're not human, you're not. You don't drink, you don't swear. You don't even have a bit of the other. You must be dead, Druid.
Not at all. I don't have to keep talking about it.
Bloody liar. You're dead, you are. You're a corpse come back from the dead to haunt us. Don't tell me I know, mate. I might be ignorant, but I know all about men. And I know more about men than you'll ever know about women.
Sit down.
I don't want to sit down.
Sit down and put this round. You're cold.
I'm not cold.
And you're frightened.
Of course I ain't. What you take me for? Well, what if I am? First Polly and then Annie, who's next?
There isn't going to be a next time.
That's what they said last time.
They're more organised now. They're doing something about it.
Oh, that's nice. You tell Polly and Annie that they will be pleased.
If the Queen is taking an interest.
So's my Aunt Fanny. If I had any sense, I'd be off like a shot. When Annie was dunning, that was meant for me.
Why do you say that?
She was wearing my hat, wasn't she?
Coincidence.
Was it coincidence that Polly Ann used to sometimes share my room? And Martha Tatum, she looked so much like me that people thought we were twins. It's me he's after.
Pure imagination.
Oh, imagination, coincidence, all right, but I'm bloody terrified.
Then why don't you go? There's nothing to keep you here, is there?
Only me mates.
No family relations.
Stop them.
Then why not go? You have the choice. I chose to live and work here. If you wished, you could choose to leave.
It'll be a waste of time. I'd only come back.
But why should you?
Because they always do. My mother, her mother, and her mother before her. Oh yes, they always talked about leaving, but none of them ever did. Or if they did, they always came running right back here again. Oh yes, the grass on the other side is always greener. And the air down a black hole does not stink. Yeah, I'm gonna get away, and I really will tomorrow.
bloke stand here.
Yeah.
I don't care what the other dockers say, there ain't any work today. They ain't taking on any more.
Why not?
I don't understand. I don't care what you've heard before, they ain't taking on any more. Now there's a way of looking at it if you'd see their point of view. It stops at all the other docks, takes on a hand or two. By the time it gets to Limehouse Reach, the ship's got all its crew. So there ain't any work today.
Hold your blimey, when's the next one due?
Should I know? I'm not the bloody oracle.
Hold your blimey, what are we to do?
Now there's no use in getting stroppy, I know that times are thin. You could be a long time waiting, so you'd better pack it in. Someday another ship will come and there'll be work again. But there ain't any work today.
Dan?
What?
Here.
What do you want?
I've got something to tell you. You know that geezer from Toynbee?
Yeah.
And you know Long Lizzie's place?
Yeah.
And you know Marbury?
Oh, of course I bloody do. What the hell you want about?
Well, I saw them both.
That's very nice for you, Dinky.
No! They was together. Oh. Close than that.
So he probably had his hand up her skirt. Maybe he was giving her one. What's wrong with that?
No, Dan, it was worse than that. They was talking.
Is this serious, thinking you're son?
Yeah. Well, this was at the door having an earwig, and I was having a gander through the back window. Well, anyway, she was all about leaving. Going away now.
Oh, that's brilliant, that, isn't it? There you go, you get some top like butter in your hands and on comes some toppy nose educated pots, and where are you, Dinky?
I don't know, Dan.
You end up working for a living, Dinky.
Working? Oh, no. I'll go down and sleep in the crippler.
Dinky, I've got a better idea. You round up the boys and I'll see you down at the steam packet.
Look at her.
Brilliant.
Bloody waxworks.
doing him over, he'd love all that.
Well, what's your idea?
We are going to fix to it good and proper. And I think I know how. Like, bang, we're going to get him dead.
Drop him in the shit, eh?
Beautifully put me on, son. Couldn't have said it better myself.
But, hey, Dad, he's a clever old geezer.
Oh, we're going to write a letter incriminating him. Get him picked up for all these murders.
Ah, that's a great idea, Dad. Yeah, that's really good, then. But there's one snake in it. What's that? None of us can write.
Trust you to put a bloody mortgage on him.
It's an important point, Dad.
Yeah, but it's only a detail, though, isn't it?
Anyway, I'm already thought of that.
Meet my bright friend, yours truly, Lord Overcoat. There you go. That's what an education can do for you. What a specimen of learning have we here. It's all. Yes, it looks like rain, doesn't it? You know, I don't quite see the day when you come in, you slogan. Unless you give millions. No, hundreds. New hope. Give a lordship a chair. Right. Sit down, your lordship.
What's it worth, eh?
Who knows?
Yeah, Dad?
Give his lordship a fight to burn.
What are they? Oh, Dad? Well, I ain't got no money.
Well, Andy, stop. You use a bit of common. Nick some.
Yeah, got a bag.
Slop, bag for his lordship.
How you doing, Dad?
Find a few doggins, roll them up in a bit of paper. Do I have to do all the thinking around here? Right, paper. Pencil.
Right. Now, what language you want it in?
What you got? Oh, I don't mind. Mix it up a bit. Put this down. Dear Charlie.
Who's the Charlie?
You are, you soppy bugger. Charlie Warren's in charge of investigating for the police.
He's Sir Charles Warren, isn't he?
Yes, so what if he is?
Well, we have to address him as, Your Excellency, Your Lordship, or maybe Your Honour.
Oh, I think you've been up in front of too many judges.
You'll hurry up, can't you? You've got to get back in the barrack.
Right, put this down. Dear Governor, beware. I shall soon be back at work again. I am down on all oars and I won't
wait
stop.
Wait a minute! Oars? Won't stop?
Until I get buckled. Right, now drop time be in it.
Drop time be in
it. Oh, not you, you soppy sod. You just put out what I tell you.
You could drop time in it by saying, I work at time be all.
Yeah, well, that's a bit obvious, isn't it? Now, you've got to be subtle, didn't you, old son?
What's that?
Bloody sly.
Oh, so, how about I'm right under your nose?
Yeah, that's a good one, Dinky. Put that down.
What?
You'll never catch me, because I'm right under your nose.
I'm a friend of all horse. Oh, that's a good slot, yeah, right there. I'm a friend of all horse, but everyone knows.
That's good.
Yeah. That rhymes!
What does?
You'll never get me. I'm under your nose. I'm a friend of all whores that everyone knows.
You'll never get me. I'm under your nose. A friend of all whores that everyone knows. You'll never get me. I'm under your nose. A friend of all whores that everyone knows. You'll never get me. I'm under your nose. A friend of all whores that everyone knows. You'll never get me. I'm under your nose.
Right, where were we?
We just dropped on me in it.
Okay. What is that? I shall give you 80. And next time I rip an oar from here to here, it will be in
Moya Square!
I was just about to say that! Run your own bloody name next time. I'll go on read it back. Taking the piss.
Oh, I can't, Temple, that's the truth.
You just wrote the bloody thing, and you do that if you can't read.
Oh, simple. I broke my glasses.
Yeah, gold haven't a lot of us. Here, mate, you read.
Yeah.
Beware, I shall soon be back at work again. I am down on all whores, and I won't until I get back. You'll never find me, because I'm right under your nose. I'm a friend of all whores that everyone knows. I'll give you a tip the next time I rip an whore from ear to ear. It'll be in my sweat.
Sure, I might select him, your girlfriend.
What do you think of that, then? Ah, that is great, Ed. Here, how about signing it?
Yeah, all right. I have to think I'm a good night, Nug.
How about Fred the Knife?
That's not bloodthirsty enough.
Slash the Knife? The deadly slasher from Flandin Street?
Well, that's the reason the bloody name itself.
Something short and simple. Slash the Ripper!
Rip the Slasher.
Jack the Slasher. Jack the Ripper!
Jack the Ripper! No, it'll never catch on.
Well, what then, Dan?
Oh, go on in, Jack the Ripper. Right, anybody got any red ink?
How about signing it in blood?
Yes. It's a nice idea. Any volunteers?
Oh, no, I can't have boy, but I ain't got any on me.
It was your idea.
Nah. I give the idea. Somebody else gives the blood.
Right, we'll do this, Fanny. All those in favour, stop giving blood, say aye.
Aye!
Aye. I hate the sight of that.
Well, close your eyes then.
Why, come on, Dan!
Well, I'll
still!
It's
fine! He's cut himself! No, I don't want to get him with it! We might as well use yours now, Dan.
Go. Work of art, if I say so myself. Now we're going to drop him in it.
Your head. I'll cut your throat.
be sod, you've got it wrong, that sweetie.
He's always up with such a dick, he's got the wrong end of the stick.
Pathetic Cockney Sparrow, Miss Saucy Rosebud.
Thank you. Couldn't wait till I'm dead. Oh, I'll give him his due. You can't sit around moaning forever. You've got to get up, stop moaning and do something about it. And that's what I intend to do.
Yeah, so will I, one day.
No, now, Liz.
Oh, I could now, dear. Not with all my business commitments.
Am I to mean a lady or a princess? Am I to live
of the night. Jack's knife flashes, and there's but one. But the last one's the ripest for Jack's idea of fun.
Look out, you bloody fool! Point where you scared the living daylights out of me.
But no need to be frightened anymore.
Well, anyway, I'm glad I got to see before I go. We didn't always see eye to eye. What, with you always wanting to make a stand and me always ready to earn a nimble shilling?
It's all over now. There's just one last scene to perform, and then the curtains can close forever.
I'm leaving, Toynbee. I'm glad I had a chance to say goodbye.
You're all the same. You would say anything except your prayers.
You're not going to start anything. I'll give you a break.
I know your crimes, your guilt. Now you must receive the punishment.
Don't start giving me all that.
When the evil is cut out of a beautiful thing, only the evil, only the beauty remains.
What are you talking about? What is the matter with you?
For years I have waited for this. You are the one I have been waiting for. Only fleeting shadows existed before you. Now that I have found you, you will never be free.
Oh my God!
For years I've waited for revenge. Now it is within my grasp. You will not escape me. Never!
Help me, one of you, can't you? It means it!
Your mind is diseased, your body corrupt.
It means it! Mr. Chairman, where are you now? I need you to stop it!
For me. Heaven alone can help you now, Marie. The body and the flesh are disposable. Only the spirit and the soul are bestowed with eternal life. Come into my warm and open arms. Come!
Aha! Caught you in the very act, you swine!
Pay no attention here, which says, I'll spring you, Jack, to pay you a bit late. What have you to say?
I confess, it was me.
No! Liar!
anthem to be sung by Mr. Druitt, Miss Mary Kelly, the entire company, but chiefly yourselves, the Queen.